Welcome to the Solar Energy Channel, where you're going to get an honest inside look at all things solar. In this video, we're going to talk about three costly mistakes to avoid when installing solar.
I'm Warren.
And I'm Charles. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel to get notified of future videos just like this.
So Charles, one of the biggest mistakes we see people make is they get sticker shock or they get stuck on the upfront cost of going solar.
Yeah, that's the price that they need to pay for the solar array. But what that does not tell them is the available incentives to them and how long that system is going to pay back, which really should be the defining decision-making process for someone, is how long is it going to take for that solar system to return the money that you laid out?
Absolutely. And you can think of it this way. If you calculate how much you're going to pay for electricity over the next 30 years by sticking with your utility compared to what you would pay going solar, it is almost in every scenario far less expensive to go solar than it is to continue to pay your utility company.
So the cheaper option is to buy that solar project versus pay 30 years worth of electric.
Yes, and not only is it a less expensive option, it also is a hedge against inflation. You get to lock in your electric rate at a fixed price at today's money and have your electricity paid for the next 30, 40, or 50 years.
Yeah, that's a great point. If you could have locked in your electric rate 30 years ago, you would see significant savings today. That is what you're doing by going solar today, locking in that price for years to come.
So let's talk about the second mistake that we see people make, and that is picking the wrong solar installer.
It's easiest to just choose the cheapest.
Yes.
But the cheapest is not always the most value to someone.
So what would you look for when you were looking for a reputable solar company?
So I think the most significant point is a production guarantee. If an installer can guarantee the production, that means they're designing the system appropriately, and they're also not overstating what the system can perform or do for you.
And these, not to be confused, that production guarantee with the solar panel manufacturer's production guarantee. So we see that oftentimes some solar companies will tout the manufacturer of the solar panel providing a guarantee, which is very different than the company itself that's installing your system, putting their money where their mouth is and saying to you that we're going to install the system, we're going to tell you how much energy it's going to produce, and we're going to guarantee you that it's going to produce that amount of energy. And then one last point in terms of evaluating a solar installer is to look at their experience, look at their reviews online, their Google reviews, Facebook reviews, and even ask them for some contacts or references and talk to their customers about their experience with that solar company.
And then the last costly mistake that you can make is not understanding the warranties that are provided to you or not provided to you when going solar.
Yes, so there are two different sets of warranties. There are the warranties that come with the components, the solar panel warranties, the inverter warranties, maybe racking warranties. And then they're separate from that are warranties that come from the solar installer, a workmanship warranty or production warranty or any other additional warranties.
Yep. So in summary, the three costly mistakes. Number one is getting stuck on the overall cost, the upfront cost, without looking at the big picture of how the solar project is going to pay for itself. The second piece is picking the right installer, that they're reputable, you know, that they have a production guarantee, that they have good reviews, that other people that have installed solar with them have positive things to say. And then the last component is understanding the warranties, the equipment warranties versus the installer's warranties.